Here in person and those who are worshiping. So we'll begin with our confession and forgiveness upon your insert in your bulletin. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the God of manna, the God of miracles, the God of mercy.
Amen.
Drawn to Christ and seeking God's abundance, let us confess our sin. God our provider, help us. It is hard to believe there is enough to share. We question your ways when they differ from the ways of the world in which we live. We turn to our own understanding rather than trusting in you. We take offense at your teachings and your ways. Turn us again to you. Where else can we turn? Share with us the words of eternal life and feed us for life in the world. Amen. Beloved people of God, in Jesus, the manna from heaven, you are fed and nourished. By Jesus, the worker of miracles, there is always more than enough. Through Jesus, the bread of life, you are shown God's mercy. You are forgiven and loved into abundant life. Amen. Could you stand and we'll sing together the gathering hymn, Gather Us In, number 532, or else on the screen.
Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also
us pray the prayer of the day together as it's found in your celebrate insert. O God, our strength, without you we are weak and wayward creatures. Protect us from all dangers that attack us from the outside, and cleanse us from all evil that arises from within ourselves, that we may be preserved through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We be seated for the reading of the lessons. Lord, who may dwell in your tabernacle, who may abide upon your holy hill.
The host of the blameless life and the people of Israel, who speak the truth from their heart.
They do not slander with the tongue, they do no evil to their friends, they do not cast discredit upon a neighbor.
And in their sight, the wicked are rejected, but they honor those who fear the Lord. They have sworn upon their health.
They do not give their money in hope of gain, nor do they take bribes against the innocent. Those who do these things shall never be overthrown.
Stand for the reading of the Gospel. The Gospel for today comes from Mark chapter 7.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now when the Pharisees and some of the scribes who had come from Jerusalem gathered around Jesus, they noticed that some of his disciples were eating with defiled hands.
For the Pharisees and all the Jews do not eat unless they thoroughly wash their hands, thus observing the tradition of the elders. And they do not eat anything from the market unless they wash it. And there are also many other traditions that they observe, the washing of cups, pots, and bronze kettles. So the Pharisees and the scribes asked him, "Why do your disciples not live according to the tradition of the elders, but eat with defiled hands?" He said to them, "Isaiah prophesied rightly about you hypocrites, as it is written, 'This people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching human precepts as doctrines.' You abandon the commandment of God and hold to human tradition." Then he called the crowd again and said to them, "Listen to me, all of you, and understand. There is nothing outside a person that by going in can defile, but the things that come out are what defile. For it is from within, from the human heart, that evil intentions come. Fornication, theft, murder, adultery, avarice, wickedness, deceit, licentiousness, envy, slander, pride, folly. All these evil things come from within. They defile a person." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. Okay, for children's time today, or kids' time, I brought this. And what is this?
Well,
yes. But what's in it?
Nothing.
Air. Air. I heard somebody say air. Yes, yes. Air is in it, so I squeeze it. If I got it close to you, you would be able to feel the air that comes out of it. So that is what fills it up. Well, I'm going to do something else with this bottle. This. Because water is very important in our baptism, right? So, now, what do we have in the bottle?
Water.
Easy, easy question. If I were to squeeze this bottle, what would happen? Should I do that talking?
No.
I won't do that talking. But yes, because whatever fills this bottle up is what comes out of it. And in our gospel reading today, Jesus is having a conversation with the Pharisees, the religious leaders of his day, about this whole kind of issue. The Pharisees were really concerned about the disciples not washing their hands before they ate. And Jesus didn't say that that's wrong to do that. But he did say that it's important to remember, for all of us to remember, that it's what that goes into us that can defile or also be good in the world. And that's where I want to land on this too. One of the things that I thought about with this water is how cleansing it is. And also, when we take in and remember and hear of God's love for each one of us, whether we're a little kid or whether we're an adult, one of the things that happens inside of us is that that can again come out into the world. It can come out in a way that we then begin to share that love, because whatever goes in comes out again. Now Jesus himself obviously was someone who took in everything about the love of God. And he lived that out. He cared about everybody that he encountered in his life. And he spoke to them and he showed them God's love. So for today, I think it's important to remember what it is we put into ourselves. If we put in the love of God, just just like the water, if I squeezed it out, it would come out of us, that love of God, into the lives of our family, into the lives of our friends, into the life of this wonderful world that God has given us. Thanks a lot, kids. I better put the top on this bottle, too. Let us pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks for this day, for the refreshing rain, for the possibilities of seeing green again, for the end to hopefully the fear of the fire at Greenwood. We ask that you be with us as we gather today. Fill our hearts with your love so that we might share this love with all that we encounter. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Dear friends, grace to you and peace from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Sit up straight, elbows off the table, napkin in your lap. Wait until everyone has been served before you begin to eat, and close your mouth when you chew. From the time each of us could sit at the dinner table, we began to learn the accepted rituals in our own families, right? In our reading from Mark's Gospel this morning, the Pharisees and scribes were watching Jesus and his disciples. And what they saw was that the disciples were not abiding by the prescribed eating rituals. They were not washing their hands before eating. The washing the Pharisees and scribes were concerned with was not simply to clean the dirt off one's hands. Their issue was with a religious or ritual washing. It was believed that through the normal tasks of the day, a person's hands became common. Hands needed to be washed before eating in order to be purified, to be made holy again. For the Pharisees, it was not just about washing hands. It was about, as we heard, the tradition and the authority behind the tradition. For them, Jesus wasn't just attempting to reform or modernize the religious laws. Jesus and his disciples appeared to be shamelessly breaking those laws. Now, it's very important to remember that Pharisees were actually a popular and relatively righteous group of their own accord. Sometimes we have such a negative view. The first century historian Josephus described the Pharisees as virtuous in conduct, both in the actions of their lives and in what they said. They happened to be a group that the audience trusts. The root of the word Pharisee means to separate. The eating rituals were meant not only for the Pharisees, but also for all of God's people to separate, to somehow distinguish themselves from others, to claim themselves in a certain way as God's people in the world. When the Pharisees confront Jesus about eating with defiled hands, as they put it, they're talking about something that all the Jews agreed should be done. The religious leaders asked Jesus, "Why do your disciples flout the rules, showing up at meals without washing their hands?" Well, Jesus doesn't answer their question, but calls them hypocrites. The word hypocrite, we probably have all used it at certain times, refers to anyone who is a pretender, anyone who acts differently than one really is. The washing ritual, according to Jesus, had become Jesus are having hearts close to God and teaching the commandments of God. Jesus is teaching us that traditional practices are not necessarily good or bad. He doesn't tap the Pharisees for the whole issue of washing hands. But for us today, rituals are not what make us Christian. It is the actions that flow out of a heart that's close to God, whether traditional or novel, that are good, that somehow spread this love of God into the world. Now, Jesus and the disciples chose to break a religious tradition, not because the tradition of claiming oneself as holy through washing was bad. Jesus chose to break with religious tradition because the emphasis had shifted from the spirit of the ritual to simply the outward practice of the ritual. Now, most of us have been raised to pray before meals, a family ritual, right? By saying the table prayer, meals are eaten with a sense of thankfulness to God for the time together as family, claiming that time. In a sense, claiming it as holy time, time set apart. But aren't there meals when the food on the table is more inviting than the time it takes to say the table prayer? The prayer may be said, but if you dig a little deeper, it may be evident that the prayer is more empty ritual than claiming that the meal together is holy. Or if you are eating a meal in a restaurant and you're with some other people and you go into the prayer posture, do you do so to claim that meal, that time, as holy? Or to pray and out of the corner of your eye watch others to see if they do the same? And if they don't pray in the same posture as you, do you make a judgment about them and about their faith life? Make no mistake about it. Jesus was very much into ritual. What we know of Jesus from Scripture is that he went to the temple in Jerusalem for major religious holidays and festivals. He worshiped regularly in the synagogues. He blessed food in public, and he went away for extended times of prayer. Jesus even taught his own disciples a prayer that we call the Lord's Prayer, that has for more than two millennia been the ritual prayer of the church. All of us need a certain amount of ritual. Choosing to be here this morning in worship or online is part of the ritual of life for us who claim Jesus Christ. To say prayers, to read Scripture, to find ways to serve others are all part of the ritual of claiming the world we live in as God's world. For Jesus, his concern wasn't about rituals. Jesus was asking the question of the source of what it is that we do as people who claim to be God's people. Whereas the Pharisees and scribes were obsessed with what happens on the outside, Jesus went straight to the heart. Now, Jesus is well aware that in our humanness, we make all kinds of determinations about others. We make judgments about others from a distance. We do that while at the same time being concerned that others not judge us prior to getting to know us, to know what comes from inside us. In the Bible, the heart is not simply the organ that pumps blood through the body. The heart is a metaphor for a person's innermost core, a person's spiritual center. Now Jesus, as we heard, knows that both good and evil come from the heart, right? And each one of us, if we are being honest with ourselves, know that to be truth in our own lives. But Jesus also knows the power of God to change hearts. Washing one's hands in Jewish life in Jesus' time was about making those hands pure. Jesus saw the washing of hands not simply for what that may have looked like on the outside, but how that washing would be a sign that God continually washes us from the inside in order to give us pure hearts. How might Christ use the rituals of our faith life to move us from the outside to the inside? Rituals of worship, prayer, of reading scripture, of service to others. They aren't simply there for show, but they're vehicles for God's Spirit to change our hearts. The rituals of faith are essential, not for show to others, but as signs to you and to me that God's renewing love, grace, and forgiveness are always at work deep within us. Rituals of faith have to do with our intention to meet God at the center of our being, our heart. And the question to each one of us is, in and through those rituals, will we be willing to have God change us from the inside out? Amen. Continue with the hymn. May children and heirs of God's promise, we pray for the church, the world. flourish. Inspire us to protect threatened habitats and ensure a sustainable future for generations to come. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for individuals in positions of authority. We especially think today of those in Afghanistan, and we pray for the soldiers who are fulfilling some heavy responsibilities now. We pray for the people there that they might be able to come out of that country if that is their desire, and that newness might come about. And we ask that you would raise up wise and discerning leaders in our federal, state, and local governments and guide them to seek the benefit of every person. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all who are in need. Support and encourage those who are unemployed and underemployed or experiencing poverty. Bring food, shelter, clothes, and stability for daily life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for this congregation, especially those beginning a new school year. We ask that you would empower teachers and school administrators, that you would guide students in their learning and development, and accompany parents, foster parents, and caregivers who provide encouragement and love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We give you thanks for the faithful departed who showed us how to honor God with our heart. Inspire us by their example and renew our faith, trusting that we will be united with them in glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Receive these prayers, O God, and those in our hearts known only to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Just find some way to express that peace to one another.
Let us give thanks to the Lord.
Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you.
receive the blessing. The blessing of God, who provides for us, feeds us, and journeys with us, be upon you now and forever. Amen. Let's join in our sending hymn number 824, This Is My Father's World, on the screen.
Thank you, Pastor.